Hello friends, we have already studied the basic scheme of protection by using the distance protection. So in case of distance protection, it is actuated by the two quantities, that is voltage and current. The ratio of voltage and current is nothing but impedance. So by measuring the impedance, the distance protection scheme operates. So in this video, we are going to study about the stepped distance protection scheme, which is used for the protection of the transmission lines. Let us study the introduction to the stepped distance protection scheme. So the distance relays which were used earlier were having the inverse characteristic of distance versus time. The meaning of inverse characteristic is that as the distance goes on increasing, the operating time goes on decreasing. This is called as inverse characteristic of distance versus time. But such type of characteristic are no more preferred. And these days, distance relays have the stepped characteristic. Now, the stepped characteristic which are used for the stepped distance protection are in two steps. First, single step and second, third step. That is in three-step protection. Now, let us study about single stepped distance relay. Now, the single step distance relay can be used where high-set instantaneous overcurrent relays cannot be used. So the typical application of the single step distance relay in the power system are: first, for the protection of transformer; second, for the feeder protection of the single section of the transmission lines; third, for the protection of the bus bars. Now the conventional distance measuring element has instantaneous distance characteristic. It means that it operates instantaneously. Now the operating time becomes infinite when the relay reach point is reached. Now meaning of reach is that the distance up to which the protective relay will operate, or the distance up to which the distance protection can be applied. So whenever this distance is reached, that is the reach, the operating time becomes infinite. Hence the distance relay is set for the value Z corresponding to the line L. Then if the fault occurs within the length L, the ideal distance relay should operate instantaneously, because the length L is the length, what that is the reach of the distance relays. Suppose the fault is occurring within this length L, then the distance relay should ideally operate instantaneously. However, the DC component of the wave, fault resistance, will influence the relay measurement and will cause overreach or underreach. Now, ideally, the relay is supposed to operate if the fault has occurred between the L length of the line, because L length is the reach of the line. But practically, due to the presence of the DC component, then due to the presence of the fault resistance, the relay feels that the distance has increased or decreased, or the impedance has increased or decreased. So the underreach or the overreach condition might occur. Now, in case of overreach condition, the relay operates even when the fault has occurred outside its zone of protection, that is outside the length of line L. So that condition is called as overreach condition. Whereas in case of underreach condition, relay does not operate even if the fault has occurred within the length of the line L. So these two conditions actually appear practically. So relay might be inoperative, or it might operate for the faults outside the zone or inside the zone. Now the figure shows single step characteristic for the high speed operation of the impedance relays. So here it is a characteristic of time versus the impedance or the length of the line. So if we see here, there is only one step. Now let us consider the condition of overreach. Now when the short circuit occurs, the current wave will have certain DC component which will cause the distance relay to overreach, that is to operate for the larger impedance than desired. Now under the short circuit condition, we have already studied the short circuit waveform has the DC component. Now due to the presence of this DC component, the total impedance of the line will increase. As a result, as the impedance has increased, the overreach condition will occur. So the tendency to overreach, that is the tendency of the distance protection scheme to operate for the faults outside its zone of protection, can be minimized if we adjust the voltage to 80% to 90% of this normal value. Now let us study the effect of arc resistance on the underreach. So the formula for the arc resistance can be approximately given by R arc is equal to 2.9 multiplied by 10 raised to 4 L divided by I raised to 1 by 4, where R arc is the resistance of the line, then L is the length of the line in meter in the open standstill air, whereas I is the fault current in amperes. Now due to this extra resistance, the distance measured by the impedance relays becomes inaccurate because the distance will get added due to the arc resistance. So the distance relay will measure an impedance of ZF plus R arc, that is the fault impedance plus the resistance of arc, where ZF is the value of impedance of the line. So by adding ZF and R arc, the measured point on RX diagram goes out of the impedance circle and relay does not operate even though the fault is within the protection zone. As the arc resistance is getting added with the total impedance of the line, the characteristic will go beyond the characteristic of the relay, that is beyond the RX diagram. So in this case, radius of the fault will be greater than the radius of the characteristic. So the relay will consider that the fault has occurred outside its zone of protection. As a result, relay will not operate. This condition is called as underreach condition. This is called underreach. Now let us study about three-stepped distance time characteristic. Now the transmission lines which have successive line sections, they can be protected by the means of three-zone distance protection scheme. So in this type of schemes, the quick protection can be obtained and backup of the schemes as well as adjoining lines and bus bars can be provided. So here both the protection, that is a primary protection as well as backup protection, can be provided. So if we refer the figure B, then the distance relay RA located at section A has three step characteristic, which is given by the dashed line marked as TA1, TA2, TA3 and TA4. This is called as first step and covers about the 80%. Let us see this in the figure. So here the figure shows the diagram for three step characteristic of the distance relay. So here the complete line is divided into three sections, A, B and C. So AB becomes first section, BC becomes second section, and the section beyond the point C is the third section. Then RA, RB, RC are the relays. TA1, TA2, TA3 are the times of RA stages. Then TB1, TB2 are the times of RB stages. And TC1 is the time of RC stage. So this is for the first section, this is for the second section, and this is for the third station. ABC are the various stations. So of the first line of section AB, it will give the instantaneous protection. TA2 is the second step of the relay at station A, that is RA, and it will cover the remaining portion of the section AB and about 20 to 50% of section BC. Let us see this in the figure. So here if we consider relay RA, then it will protect only 80% of the line. The remaining percent of the line will be protected in B section. So here there is only one step, here there are two steps, and finally we get three steps. So in this way, the total section of the line can be protected in three steps. Now the third step is having the timing of TA3 and it will cover the entire remaining line. The steps are obtained by the following procedure. First is by changing the taps on the auxiliary voltage transformer. Then second is switching the resistance in relay restraint coil at the preset time intervals by the means of the time element. Third is separately measuring element for zone 2 and zone 3. Now let us consider the power swings. So power swings are nothing but sudden change in load condition in the system between the load and generating station. Suppose there are the sudden change in the load conditions between the generating station and the load, then this condition will cause the power swings. Now the starting element AC in the distance scheme generally respond to power on off on the transmission line. The overcurrent AC is radially affected. Now during the power swings, there is a flow of equalizing current in the transmission line. The current caused by the power swings flows equally in phases, which will cause the overcurrent relay, that is AC, to pick up in all the phases. So the minimum impedance AC responds to ratio WI. During the power swing, the voltage will also drop at certain points of the system in addition to the equalizing current. Such starting relay of all three phases can pick up during the heavy power swings. So whenever heavy power swings occur, all the relays in all the three phases should operate. Therefore, the overcurrent AC or the impedance AC operate during the power swings. So the overcurrent AC will sense the overcurrent fault. Impedance AC will sense the distance or the impedance. During the heavy power swings, both will operate. Hence, the measuring element, that is ME, has to decide whether to operate the relay or to block the relay. So if the fault is occurring in the zone of protection, then the measuring element will operate the relay. But if the fault is occurring outside the zone of protection, then the measuring relay has to block the relay. So the decision of operating the relay or blocking the relay will be taken by the measuring element. In general, distance relays having more characteristic are less susceptible to the power swing because of their narrow characteristic. So more relay has the narrow characteristic, hence it is less susceptible to the power swing. So use of the more relay is considered. Generally during the power swings, out of step blocking relay will operate. If the measuring element operates within a certain time after the operation of the blocking relay, then the tripping is allowed. Otherwise, the tripping is not allowed. Now the modern distance relays which are used, they are stable over the wide range of the springs, so they do not trip unselectively if the power swings revert to the normal conditions fairly soon. Now these power swings are only present for a small period of time. After some time they will go back to the normal. So the relay has to decide whether to trip or not. For the heavy power swing, the relay should operate. But the power swing for the very small amount of time should not be considered as the fault. If the condition prevails, only then the relay trips. That is, if the power swings keep coming again and again or they have very high magnitude, then the relay will operate. So in this way, we have studied the step distance protection scheme for the protection of transmission line. It operates in two types, for single step and three step. Basically, three step distance protection can protect the entire transmission line. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekida and do subscribe our channel Ekida. Thank you.